where you're heading, mister.
That town called Rio Arriba?
That's right.
That's where I'm heading.
Are you Mr. Sims?
No.
The sheriff don't want any strangers in town.
Not till day after tomorrow.
Then I'm in time.
For what?
The hangin'. Tomorrow, ain't it?
Yes.
So just turn around and go back. You're welcome to Rio Arriba the day after.
I've ridden 100 miles to see this hangin'.
That's for the sheriff to decide. Unbuckle your gun belt. Give me your rifle. Don't take the hand off the butt. Right in slow. I'll be right behind you. That's his office. Picked him up at San Marcos Pass. Said he came to see the hanging.
I told you not to let anybody through except Sims. I'll get back there and see you do it.
Yes, sir.
Somebody?
Rio Arriba's a quiet little town. We don't get many strangers here. What do you want?
Like your deputy said, I come here to see the hanging.
Where'd you ride in from?
Winthrop.
You rode 100 miles over the mountains just to watch a hanging? Know the men are gonna die?
No.
Oh, you just like to watch hangings, is that it?
Now keep your guns. You stay away from this jail while you're in town.
What time is the hanging?
6 o'clock in the morning.
Start serving breakfast at the hotel at 5:30. You can watch it on a full stomach.
Shot my bank full of holes, killed my teller. But we caught them red-handed, all four of them. Now, sure, they didn't get a dime.
When you hang them tomorrow?
Do it slow.
Well, you got me confused, young fella.
Aren't you Mr. Sims?
The hangman from Silver City?
No.
If you're not the hangman, what are you doing here?
Just passing through.
Maybe he came here to help him break out.
Just looking to feed my horse and find a hotel room for the night.
Yes, sir, I'm the hotel clerk. I can find you a room, sir. May I take your horse?
All right.
You didn't answer my question, mister.
I didn't hear you ask one.
What's your business here, Rio Riva?
Put it down.
We got enough trouble without you starting more.
Folks are a bit edgy today. Might be a good idea for you to stay in the hotel.
All right, break it up. That's just what we're trying to avoid, a crowd. You ought to know that, all of you. Come on, break it up.
You going to church tonight, Tom?
Hey, Ma?
Yes, Father, coming. Are you, Tom?
Yeah, I'll be there.
Willie, take care of this horse. Saturday, we give him a fair trial. Well, we never had a hanging in this town before, so we had to send to Silver City for a man to do the job. And we all thought you was him.
Well, it's not my line. But if you don't show up, I might accommodate you.
Tony. Take my horse, and I'll meet you at the store.
Yes, Miss Josefa.
Jim?
It's me, all right.
This is an occasion. It deserves a celebration.
Yes, it does.
Come on. I'll buy you beer. Nego, dos cerveza, por favor.
Si, señor.
Sit here. Brings you to Rio Riva, Jim.
Nice country.
What are you doing here?
I have some business with the sheriff's office. Gracias, señor.
Have you been back to New Orleans?
No.
We had fun. Since my father died, I don't get to travel much. Where have you been?
I got a little ranch outside Winthrop.
I never heard about it.
Small place.
Sometimes I wish mine were. It's too much for a woman to handle.
You never got married?
Nope. I just can't seem to find the right man.
Maybe you're too particular.
That's what my father said. When we met in New Orleans, I was husband hunting.
You were?
I guess I did behave a little foolishly.
I don't know. Maybe you were smart.
Did you ever marry?
Yes, I did. Fine girl.
I'm sure. I have to go. How long are you going to be in town?
Just until tomorrow.
Oh. Well, it's good to see you again, Jim.
Amigo? Whiskey?
Si, senor.
Willie! Take Mr. Sims' horse to the stable. I'll tell the sheriff you're here.
Mind if I join you?
Sit down.
Can I buy you a drink?
I have mine.
I hate to drink alone. Oh, bartender, whiskey. Sims is the name, from Silver City. I've come to perform a little service for you folks.
Say, what does a man do for a little recreation in this town? At night, I mean.
I'm a stranger here myself.
Mr. Sims?
Oh, Sheriff, come in and have a drink.
No, thanks. Would you care to inspect the gallows and have a look at the prisoners?
Oh, it's plenty of time for that. Had a long, dusty trip. Think I'd like to freshen up a bit.
Your room's ready, Mr. Sims.
Oh, thank you. I hope I see you again, sir. Of course, not professionally. I'll drop over to jail this afternoon.
I wonder if I could see the prisoners.
Said you didn't know him.
I never met him, but I think I know him.
They do you a bad turn?
I've been following them for 6 months, tracking them up and down the state. Relief to catch up with them and find out the law's gonna do the job for me.
You're sure they're the same bunch?
There's two white men, a half-breed, and an Indian, right?
That's them.
We never had anything like this in Rio Riva before. Too bad when it's over.
You're wasting a lot of good lumber. A tree would have done just as well.
They were sentenced to be hanged, not lynched. Are they giving you any trouble?
No.
Meet them? They ate. All right, come here. On your feet, all of you. I said move!
Smoke, stranger?
Shut up.
What are you gonna do, punish us if we talk?
I was hoping you'd bring us a woman, Sheriff.
I can know their names.
Thank you.
much obliged.
Who's that, Sheriff?
Don't you know him?
I never saw him before in my life.
He came to see you hang. This is the last night. Now watch him.
Yes, sir.
And don't talk to him. If they want anything, call me.
Sheriff.
Hmm?
You think I might get off long enough to go to church tonight?
I'll see. Do what I can. Well, Father Bailey's here to see you.
I told you to keep him out of here.
Your mother's with him.
I don't want to see her either.
Primo, what time is it?
I don't talk to you.
Now, you're the only one we got nothing against, Primo.
Primo takes good care of us. We all love him.
Well, I don't love you.
Sure you do. The first time I have a little Nino, I'm going to name him Primo after you.
You joke. You should be praying. Get down!
What you thinking, sir?
I'm wondering who that stranger is.
From the way he looked, he sure didn't come here to help us.
I can't place him.
He seemed to know you. He looked at you the hardest.
Who was that?
Hmm?
You ever see that man before?
No. But he's got the face of a hunter.
Zach, we don't have much time.
Don't you think we know that?
We can't just wait here.
Go ahead.
Bang your head on the bars and yell. They'll hang you right now.
Darnest thing sometimes.
Good evening, Mr. Steinmetz.
Hello, Tom. Emma, you happen to know where I put my stomach powders?
Oh, yes, Father.
Did you get me one?
No.
Just in case. Tom, Emma is a fine girl.
Yes, sir, I think so, too.
The world's big, and there are many wonderful places in it. And I'd like for Emma to see them.
Well, sir, I wanted to...
Let me finish, Tom. I was a pack peddler when I came here. It's taken me a quarter of a century to make what I got today. And now I'm too old to enjoy it. I want Emma to enjoy it. But not in this out-of-the-way small town. I want her to marry some man who lives in Philadelphia or Boston. Has his business there, mixes with educated people. Am I wrong to want that for her, Tom?
No, sir.
Right now, Emma thinks she loves you. I guess she does. But she's never had a chance to meet anyone else. I want to give her that chance.
Now, what has he been telling you?
Oh, about Philadelphia and Boston.
Gosh, wouldn't you love to go there?
Good evening, Sheriff.
Good evening, Mrs. Steinmetz. Emma, Tom.
Must be big doings in church tonight. Looks like everyone in town is going.
That's right. It's our annual novena to St. Anthony. When would you like to look at the prisoners?
I'd like to finish my cigar first.
All right, there's no hurry. Finish your cigar.
Think I'll stretch my legs.
Open.
Jim?
Come in.
I'm on my way to church. I thought that you might like to go.
Well, I don't go to church anymore.
Jim, I don't understand.
Very simple. I just don't go.
Sorry.
Very sorry. Step up. If you'll allow me, I'll walk you there.
Of course.
You think the sheriff would let us go to church, Preeny?
No.
It's all right if I look at it from the window, isn't it?
All right.
Everyone's going to church. You think they pray for us, Primo? Primo, will you pray for us?
You want me to?
You're a good man, Primo. God will listen to you.
What should I pray for?
That we go to heaven.
I can't do that. But I will pray that God will forgive you.
I'll settle for that.
What's it, Tucker? How soon you think before he'll make his try?
When everyone's in church.
No talking!
I'm praying, Primo.
Do you have any children, Jim?
Little girl.
How old is she?
3.
Pretty?
She's pretty. Like her mother was.
Was?
She's dead.
I'm sorry. Good evening, Sheriff.
Evening, Josefa.
You must have been very much in love.
Still am.
Beautiful evening, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
Thanks, Josefa. Guess I needed to talk to a woman.
There's a woman inside I think you might do well to talk to.
Well, should we take a look at our bad boys now?
Fine. Remo.
Yes, sir.
Everything all right?
Yes, sir.
You go on to church now. Mr. Sims is with you.
Thank you, Sheriff. Thank you, too.
And Primo.
Yes, sir.
Come back as soon as the service is over. Mr. Sims may want to get to bed early on account of tomorrow.
Well, that's all right, Sheriff. Take your time. Don't worry about me.
Thank you, sir.
All right. On your feet, all of you. Over here.
Can't we have a little more light in here, Sheriff?
Sure.
I'd like to get a good idea of each man's size and weight.
Reach! Reach!
We'll take her along.
She'll slow us down.
I won't rush us as long as we've got her. I get the horses.
I think we're all aware of the shadow that has fallen over Rio Arriba. The gallows casts a shadow even at night. Tomorrow for a minute to die. That they die is the just fulfillment of Caesar's law. But I would remind you that these four men are also creatures of God, eligible for his mercy. Pray for them as he would. If you recall, there was also scaffolding at Golgotha. And Christ, bleeding and dying, took time in his agony to turn and to pardon a common thief. Remember that tomorrow. For all of you, it'll be daybreak. But for these four men, it'll be the midnight of their lives. Your prayers will help them.
And let's get going.
Where?
Ashram.
They stole Bob's horse.
I'm on a horse.
We can't find Emma. They must have taken her with them.
Josefa, they've taken Emma. What'll I do? Please help me, please.
Mr. Steinmetz, we'll all help. I'll get my horse and go with you. Come on, Jim.
You can't overtake them tonight before they get to San Marcos Pass. One of them can hold that against 100.
Aren't you coming with us?
It'll be a long, hard chase. I can use some sleep. I'll wait till morning.
Do you mean to tell me after what's happened tonight, you can just go back to that hotel and go to sleep?
Yeah.
And then what?
I'm gonna find her. That's the last thing I do. Night.
The woman along, they can overtake us.
Tell her you stay here and hold them off till sundown. We'll turn up at the top of the pass and head for Elder Gorge. We'll make camp and wait for you there.
Please, let me go, please.
Later.
Please, my father will give you anything.
I've already got all he can give me.
Everybody, let's go! Come on!
I'm talking about no boys back there! Come on! Everybody!
Get your horse, go into town, and get a wagon back here. Quick! Go on.
Take this man down with the others.
Primo, Murphy looks very bad. There's nothing I can do for him. You've got to get him out of here.
Do what you can. I've sent for a wagon. Back to town. All we can do now is wait. Then we'll follow them over the pass. Once they get into the open desert, we can circle them.
Once they get to the desert, we can lose them.
They got Emma.
I'm not going to take that chance.
Hold it.
Come on, Tom.
Wait. Primo's right. You can't rush them. But don't worry about losing them.
What do you know about it? Who are you?
You're a stranger here. You say you can't rush them. That's all right for you, but me, it's my daughter who is in danger. Maybe you want us to lose them.
I've been following them for 6 months. I'm not going to lose them now. If I was you, I'd pick out 12 of these men and send the rest of them home. Especially the old fellow and the lady over there.
I can't send Mr. Steinmetz home.
He's not going to do us any good. He's just going to get in the way.
He won't leave.
I'm sorry. Primo just told me you don't want me along.
Well, that's right.
Emma's gonna need me when we catch up with them.
With you along, we might not catch up with them. You might get hurt. I wouldn't want to see that.
Are you worried about me?
These are mean men we're after. They're real mean.
For the gorge, you must turn off here.
You still like the gorge idea?
Yes, we told Taylor we'd wait for him there.
We can move faster on the desert.
That's where they'll be looking for us.
If we keep moving and ride hard, we can reach the border in 2 days.
In the desert, we can only ride at night. 2 days and we'll burn up. She won't last that day.
Well, why do we need her?
I need her. We'll head for the gorge and hole up there till they stop searching. Lead, Luhan.
What do you think, Mr. Douglas?
Sun's going down. That's what he waited for. We can't track him by night. Let's move ahead as long as we can see.
Everybody, get mounted.
Some coffee.
Can't we go on? Just you and me?
like looking for a needle in a haystack.
Yeah, but I'm worried about Emma.
Well, suppose we were lucky enough to stumble across him. You don't think they'd give up without a fight? She'd be the first they'd kill.
Here is one of them! Here he is! Come on, all of you! Come here, all of you! Help! I found one of them! There he is, see? Must be one of them.
This is not one of them.
That must be the real Mr. Sims. Timepiece?
No, sir.
Here. Take mine. You go back to the rim of the gorge and fire a shot every 5 minutes.
But what good'll that do?
Well, sound carries a long way in these canyons. If they're in there, they'll hear it. Make them wonder. Keep them up all night. Take their minds off Emma. One of us will relieve him. Every hour. Keep it up all night.
You take turns standing watch. I'll look after the horses.
I'll take the last turn.
You'll take the first.
I'll take the first watch. Can't sleep anyway.
Out of this, you want to stick with me or split up?
Well, I haven't given it much thought.
Well, I have. You're a good man, Taylor. I should hate to lose you.
Well, I sort of like having a man behind me I can count on. That Peral's a louse. The engine makes me nervous. Never know what's going on inside his head.
I never crossed a man that rode with me.
Well, neither did I.
I need you with me.
Back goes double.
I got one weakness I feel you should know about.
What's that?
Women.
Every man's entitled to one weakness. Mine's cards.
You think Lujan needs some help with the horses?
Well, now, he just might.
Is that silk?
Where'd that come from?
It's an old trick they want to keep us awake.
Get back on watch.
Go to sleep. You never hear the shot that kills you.
Thank you.
here, all right, not too long ago. Looks like those shots of ours changed their plan.
Track show, they went down the gorge.
Yeah. Could be the Indians thinking to throw us off.
Hella!
Stop that, you idiot!
I want Emma to know we're following.
Now they all know.
You said we'd lose them in the gorge.
They're smarter than you thought, rat man.
There's only one man that could have followed us down here. The one with the eyes of the hunter. The strange one. That the sheriff brought down to the jail to look at us.
He's right. I saw him with a posse up in San Marcos Pass.
Well, who is he? What's he talking us for? Maybe she knows.
I never saw him before he came to Rio Arriba.
Why did he come?
To watch you hang. It's the truth.
Let her go. He must know one of you.
Maybe it's you he's after.
How could he be? I never saw him before.
No, he don't look like no banker or the owner of any place we ever robbed.
Let's kill him. Then the others can't follow us.
It's a very good idea. You do it.
Let Luan do it.
No, no. We need Luan to take us to the border. You catch up with us tonight.
But why me?
It was your idea.
What is it, Mr. Douglas?
You see some movement up there in that tall grass?
No, sir.
I think there's a man up there waiting for us to come within range.
Why don't we make him fire first?
And one of us would be dead.
Are we gonna wait for sundown again?
Primo. You take the lead. You and the others circle the hill. Stay just outside rifle range of that tall grass. I'll go up the other side.
Why are you doing this for us, Mr. Douglas?
Not doing it for you, Mr. Steinmetz.
Keep moving. I'm waiting for you.
I'm here. Drop it. Remember that woman?
No.
Now look at it.
No.
You're lying.
I never saw her before. I swear I didn't.
You stopped at my ranch 6 months ago.
I never saw your ranch. I don't even know where it is.
There were four of you.
We never did. Please, you gotta believe me.
She begged and cried and pleaded too, didn't she? Please leave me alone. I have a baby. I have a husband. Please leave me alone. Take anything you want, but please leave me alone. Didn't she? But it didn't help much.
I never saw that face before. I was never on your ranch. I never did anything to you.
Which one of you? Which one of you did it?
I didn't do it. I've done some bad things. Robbed, stole, I've run cattle. But I never killed no woman.
Come on, talk. There were four of you. Which one? Which one?
Don't do it. Please, let me live. Please, let me live. Please. I've got a wife and baby, too. Oh, don't do it. Please, don't do it. I'll do anything for you. Please.
And it was all four of you.
Holy.
Father.
Morning, Sarah.
How's the sheriff?
Much better.
Good. Poor Mrs. Burrell. I feel so sorry for her.
It's hard to believe one child can bring so much happiness, so much grief.
Any news of Primo and Lynn?
Jim Douglas is along with him, isn't he? Came to church with you.
Yes. Do you know him?
Years ago.
I hadn't seen him in 5 years. But he's changed. What happened to him, Father?
Quite a lot. He was out tending his cattle. Came home late one evening to find that his house had been ransacked and robbed, and his wife had been raped and murdered.
Awful.
I think that's what's brought him to Rio. Jim Douglas is not the kind of man to just watch a hanging. Must be some connection between those four men and what happened at the ranch. I think that Jim must believe that those men committed the crime.
Did they?
Nobody knows. I doubt if Jim knows.
But his child, Father, what happened to the child?
A ranch hand and his wife were taking care of her.
Child could have been mine. I was in love with Jim Douglas, and he asked me to marry him. I didn't have the sense to say yes.
married a good man.
How do I get to his ranch?
Well, after San Marcos Pass, you take the Winthrop Road to Canyon Diablo. There'll be a small stone cabin.
You think Peral got our man?
I hope they got each other.
Look.
Yeah, there's Peral now.
He got our man. I feel better.
That's not Peral.
It's the hunter.
How could they have caught us so soon? We rode all night.
They haven't. It's only one man.
Well, we can handle one man easy enough.
He's marking a trail for the posse.
Let's wait for him.
And let the posse gain on us?
Go on. I'll catch up with you.
Why you?
I'm a better shot. And I don't like a man dogging my trail.
What do you think, Luhan?
There's sure to be someone there.
Then we'll get something to eat.
We need fresh horses more than food.
Maybe we'll get both.
Come back here!
Now, where did you think you were going? Ah, don't cry. I'm not gonna make you walk. I'm gonna let you ride. Right up here next to me.
We haven't seen Douglas since he killed Parral. He must have gone back.
Douglas didn't go back. Look. Howdy.
Howdy.
Any spare little food? We haven't eaten all day.
Food's pretty scarce around these parts.
We're willing to pay for hospitality.
Where are you heading?
Rio, Reba.
Oh, well, you're lost. You're headed in the wrong direction. Rio Reba's across the Diablo to the north.
You can spare a little grub for the lady, can't you?
I guess so.
We'd be satisfied with a cup of coffee.
You know what happened to your horse? Well, just one word and you'll get the same.
I won't have...
Hey! Douglas Ranch is about 4 miles west of here. But I don't know if they got any horses or not.
Don't got any foolish ideas.
What's that?
Them's my teeth.
Where do you keep your gold?
I haven't got any.
What are you mining for?
Silver. So far, I haven't found any. Well, I gotta get back to work.
Go ahead. Don't let us stop you.
Go and see what it was.
Let's go. The posse's coming.
Go ahead. Go ahead. I'll be along.
I said no!
Miner's cabin. Douglas's ranch should be about 4 more miles west.
Who's that?
That's John Butler, my neighbor.
Poor devil never harmed anybody in his life.
Now they've killed him. Let's get him in the house.
Jim! Jim, come here!
Straight to the border. I'm going by my place and pick up a fresh horse. I'll meet you at the river.
Yes, sir.
Everybody, get mounted!
Parece tu padre. No los conozco. rato vinieron dos hombres, se llevaron dos caballos y se fueron hacia el río. Se llevaron los mejores caballos. ¿Qué hacemos? Lo siento mucho. El nene y yo estábamos solas. Pablo se fue a trabajar.
Está bien, Monita. No te apures. Not far behind them, but they took the only horses that were here. Helen, this is Josefa. She's a good friend of mine. A very good friend. I want you to stay with her until I get back. I don't know when that'll be.
I'll take care of her. Just as if she were my own.
Guess I haven't been much of a father. Bye.
God bless you, Jim.
Looks like it, all right.
Mr. Douglas, here are the tracks.
This is where they crossed the river.
Mr. Douglas!
This is the international border. We can't go any further.
I can't. Señora, did you see two men on horseback cross the river here today?
No entiendo.
Vio a dos hombres a caballo cruzar el río por aquí hoy.
Ah, sí. Mire, bajaron ahí, luego cruzaron el río, se fueron así, dieron la vuelta, se fueron por acá y se fueron para San Cristóbal.
San Cristóbal. ¿Para dónde queda eso?
Ah, mire. San Cristóbal está, se va usted por aquí, da la vuelta, sube y un poquitito más adelante está San Cristóbal.
¿A qué distancia queda?
Como a 20 kilómetros.
Muchas gracias.
they want with me.
Look at it.
I see it. What of it? It's a watch.
Look at the picture.
What about it? Who is she?
You remember her?
I never saw that woman before in my life. Now get out of here. I'm tired of you dogging my trail.
She was my wife. Raped and killed by you.
I tell you, I never saw that woman before in my life. Now get away from me.
Bendito sea Dios que llegaste, padre.
Mira, Ángela.
Tenemos todo el dinero necesario para el resto de la vida. Cógelo para ti, cógelo.
Sí, pero el niño está enfermo.
¿Que está enfermo?
Muy enfermo.
¿Pero cuánto tiempo está enfermo?
Mucho, hace mucho.
Vente.
Pero él tiene fiebre, mucha fiebre.
Sí, pobrecito. Necesitamos refrescarle la frente.
Bueno, le voy a poner un poquito de agua. A ver si se le quita un poquito la fiebre. Pero es que no hay agua. Voy a buscar un poquito. Vengo enseguida.
¿No hay agua? ¿No hay agua?
Mientras tú cuidas al niño, yo te voy a hacer algo de comer.
Where's the Indian who rode up here on that horse?
Perdone, señor, no le entiendo nada. Mi hijo está muy enfermo. Mi esposo fue a traer agua al arroyo. ¿Quién es usted? ¿Qué va a hacer? Quería matar.
Ángela.
Traele algo de comer.
Why don't you kill me? Well, you got a chance. I came here to kill you.
I have no reason to kill you. Why do you hunt me?
Just look at that picture.
Your wife and baby?
Yeah.
She's very pretty. My wife and baby, they are pretty. Why do you hunt me?
You ever see that woman before?
No.
There were four men. Two white men, a half-breed, and an Indian. They robbed my ranch house and they killed my wife.
I have never seen your ranch.
The horse you rode up here, you stole from my ranch.
I did not know that was your ranch and I didn't see any woman.
If you've never been to my ranch before, where'd you get this bag of money?
That I took from a miner that I met in Canyon Diablo. We were at his house. We ate his eggs and meat. And then he ran down the hill to hide that money and Zachary killed him. I took that money from his hand when he was dead.
Buckler was the one who told me 6 months ago, the day my wife was murdered, that the four of you, you came straight from my ranch past his place.
It is true. We did come past his place. But we did not come from the direction of your ranch. We came straight from the border.
Where did Butler get that money? It was stolen from my house the day that... with my wife.
What I have told you is the truth.
God.
people of Rio Arriba are thankful that you brought justice where they failed.
You don't understand, I didn't kill them for the sake of justice.
You were a member of an armed posse legally sent out to get them, dead or alive.
No, Father, I didn't kill them for anything that they did here in Rio Arriba. I killed them for revenge. Revenge for something that they didn't even do. I set myself up as the judge, the jury, and the executioner. They swore that they were innocent. One of them even, he begged on his knees for his life. I wouldn't listen. I killed them for something that they didn't do.
Well, Jim, let me point this out to you. By telling me what you have and feeling as you do, you're already a step ahead of a lot of other men that have been in your shoes. That doesn't mean that I'm condoning what you've done, but at least you haven't excused your own actions by saying, as many men would, that these men were evil and should die anyway, and that you merely carried out a legal execution.
I know that, Father, but it doesn't help. I was wrong. Wrong.
Some people think prayers help.
Ladies and gentlemen, there's no need for me to tell you. The emergency arose, and the man appeared. Sir Douglas, it's not often a man gets to do so much for his neighbors, do it like you did. We want you to know we'll be forever grateful, and you'll be in our hearts always.
Thank you. And in your prayers, please.